Minister, now the leader of the opposition, Mr. Sambandan, to second the motion.
Okay, Mr. Speaker. It is with a great deal of humility, sir, that I rise today to say a few words on this motion moved by the Prime Minister commemorating the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, perhaps the noblest human being who traversed the earth in the past several centuries. The country of his birth, India, was under foreign rule. He was convinced that the Indian people should receive independence and rule themselves. He organized several movements to achieve this objective. The non-cooperation movement. He took the view that the Indian people, if they refused to cooperate with the British rulers, the British would not be able to rule them. The objective of this movement was to make the British people, British rulers, lose control of India. This was the non-violent movement based upon Ahimsa, Satyagraha, the truth, and civil disobedience, an illustration of the civil disobedience movement was the Salt Satyagraha, the Dandi March, designed to resist taxation and British monopoly over salt. He convinced the people that power lay with them, and if they engaged in non-violent civil disobedience, they would emerge victorious and independent. That the British would wilt in the face of such resistance. And the British did wilt and realize that India could no longer be ruled against the will of the Indian people. Then there was a Quit India movement. He called upon the British to quit India. He told the British in no uncertain terms that they had no business to be in India, that rule of India must be left in Indian hands. The Conservative government under Winston Churchill attempted to resist his demand. The defeat of the Conservative government and the election of the Labour government in the mid-40s somewhat changed British attitude and resulted in roundtable conferences and negotiations that led to independence of India. Before Mahatma Gandhi started his satyagraha in India, his civil disobedience in India, based on Ahimsa, he was a young lawyer practicing in South Africa. And as a young lawyer, when he practiced in South Africa, he led the Indian people and the South African people against apartheid. There was one incident that happened in South Africa which attracted the attention of the whole world. And that was when Gandhi defied apartheid and traveled on a train in which a compartment had been reserved for the whites in that compartment, defying white British rule, white South African rule. Result being that Mahatma Gandhi was pulled out of the compartment and thrown onto the pavement. I remember, sir, listening to a speech made by President Barack Obama of the United States some years ago shortly after he assumed office as President of the United States. At a joint session of the Indian Parliament, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, when President Barack Obama said, "My journey to the White House commenced on the day Mahatma Gandhi was thrown out of that train in which he was seated in a compartment meant for whites. That was the day on which my journey to White House commenced." So really, sir, Mahatma Gandhi's influence was not merely in India. Mahatma Gandhi's influence was all over the world. And Mahatma Gandhi was a person who I think was largely responsible for many countries in Asia achieving independence, including Sri Lanka. And we must all be grateful to this great son of India for the concept of nonviolence, ahimsa, satyagraha, truth and civil disobedience, which he introduced into the thinking of ordinary people as an instrument to fight injustice, inequality, and subservience. He also so united India. He unified India. India is a large country, currently with a population of 1,200,000 people. There are both large states and small states in India. He preserved their identity. Every Indian, whether he was a Bengali, a Punjabi, or a Telugu, or a Malayali, or a Tamil, first called himself an Indian. Mahatma Gandhi united them. Mahatma Gandhi unified India and made India one country in which the Indian people lived with self-respect, which belonged to the Indian people. Their own identities, individual identities came thereafter. He was responsible for ensuring, as the Prime Minister said, that there was every effort made not merely to achieve political independence, but to bring about self-sufficiency for the people of India. I think Mahatma Gandhi played a big role in regard to that matter, and he also played a big role in uniting India, keeping India together, not merely by recognizing linguistic identity and carving out states on the basis of linguistic identity, but ensuring that his linguistic identity did not in any way surpass the Indian identity. While preserving the Indian identity, he ensured that all Indians, with their own languages, their own culture, their own civilization, their own history, were able to preserve their independence, their individuality, their identity in their own states. This was a great contribution that Mahatma Gandhi paid to the great service that he rendered to the Indian people. I might mention, sir, thinking of our own country and the situation in our own country, I've often thought that in 1977, when there was a UNP government elected under President J.R. Jayawardenep, and we ourselves had come to Parliament in large numbers from the north and the east of this country, we could have averted an armed struggle in this country if we had resorted to satyagraha, civil disobedience, and ahimsa on the lines of what Gandhiji taught us. I think it was a great mistake that in 1977, we, the Tamil members of Parliament, were elected very substantially to Parliament from the North and the East. We won all the seats in the North and the East, except one seat, which we lost by a few hundred votes. if we had launched a Satyagraha campaign against the Sri Lankan government on the basis of Ahimsa, on the basis of Satyagraha, truth, and civil disobedience, we could have averted an armed struggle and won our own self-rule in our areas without violence. I think it was a mistake that we did not engage in such a course of action. It is my hope that we will never have violence in this country again, that we will abide by the teachings of Mahatma Gandhi, and if the government fails to deliver on its commitment to find an adequate solution to the national question, the Tamil people, instead of resorting to violence, will resort to Satyagraha, will resort to Ahimsa, on the basis of truth, on the basis of civil disobedience, to win their rights. I think, sir, I thank the Prime Minister and the government for introducing this motion today in Parliament and giving us an opportunity of paying our respects, our highest regard to the late Mahatma Gandhi, who not merely influenced the course of events in India, but who influenced the course of events in the whole world. I thank you, sir.
Thank you, Honorable Leader of the Opposition, Chief Government Whip, Honorable